Hi everyone and welcome to this new tutorial on Harfang Studio. Today we will see how to add some content in a scene. Let's start by observing an existing scene. In the Explorer window, you will find all the scene content. In Studio, all this content is displayed as nodes. Some nodes are objects, some are lights, instances, camera. These different functionalities are assigned by components which can be added to the node. Aligned with the name of the node, you can see a tiny icon that represents the type of the node, based on the components related to it. When you select a node, its information is displayed in the Inspector window on the right. I will select this node as an example. Back to the Inspector window, I can access its name and all the components related to it. Components are represented by collapsible sections. You can click on the labels to expand or collapse them. Studio proposes you to add several types of nodes in your scene. But before looking into this, I will show you how to create a new scene. So go to the bar menu, File, New, Scene. You can choose the name of your scene and its location. I will create it at the root of the project and name it My Scene. Click on Save to validate. Studio will then automatically open your scene. Here is the default scene that comes empty with a black background. Let's start adding the most basic element, a simple node. Go to the menu bar, Scene, Add, and Node. Select the new node in the Explorer window and go check the Inspector window. A simple node is composed of a name. You can set it by clicking on the Names field. Just below, you will find a checkbox that allows you to enable or disable the node. Note that when the node is disabled, you can see it in the 3D view or interact with it in any way. All the properties given by the components are inaccessible, but we will focus on this point later. The last thing is the transform component, which gives to the node its ability to move around the 3D space. So the node has a position, a rotation, and a scale. The parent field and the node manipulation will be explained in a future tutorial. You will find these three basic properties in every other node type. Note that a simple node is not represented by any icon in the type column of the Explorer window. Let's look at the object node. In the menu bar, go to Scene, Add, Object. Basically, an object node is one of the two node types which display a 3D geometry in the scene. It will ask you to choose one from your project resources before creating the node. Geometry files are created when you import a 3D file. A complete tutorial about how to import your objects is also available. Don't hesitate to look at it if you want to know more about geometry files. In the resource browser, you will find all the project content organized in the same way as in the project window. Folders are on the left and files on the right. Studio will only display the usable files in the current operation. In this case, you will only find the geometry files. I will choose this geometry and validate with the Select button. Now, you can select the new node object from the Explorer window and note that the icon for an object node is a little cube. In the Inspector, you will find the node name, the Enable checkbox, the Transform component, and a new component named Object. The Object component represents the link to the geometry file that we selected in the previous step. You can change it at every moment by clicking on the Browse button here. The Clear button will remove the actual link without adding a new one. The Material section is a big part, and we will talk about it in another tutorial. For now, please note that you can change the Color object by clicking here and select your color thanks to the Color Picker. As you can see, we can't really see our node object because there is no light in the scene. So let's add a light node to see the scene content. In the menu bar, go to Scene, Add, Light, and choose the point light. Select your new light in the Explorer window. The icon for a light node is a little sun. In the Inspector, you will find the name, the Enable checkbox, the Transform, and the new light component, with all the lightning setting. As we saw before, there are three light types, point, spot, and linear. For this tutorial, we will only use the point light and the main settings. All the other light features will be covered in another tutorial. Let's start by moving the light around our object. To do this, go to the Transform component in the second field of the position and replace 0 by 1. The light is now located at 1 meter on the vertical axis. You can change the light color by clicking on the white square aligned with the diffuse label and select your color in the color picker. Just below, you can change the light intensity by replacing the value. You can also test the enabled feature. Click on the checkbox to disable your light. Your object is again not visible, as when we didn't have any light. Note that all the components options are now grayed out, and no longer editable. The node name in the Explorer window is also grayed out. This tells you that the node is now disabled. Let's reactivate our node light and check the next node type. We will now add a camera node. In the menu bar, go to Scene, Add, Camera. Again, select your new camera in the Explorer and take a look at the icon type, which is a little camera. As we have seen in a previous tutorial, all scenes have an implicit perspective view. It allows you to visualize a scene as soon as it's created. You can also use your own created camera to visualize your scene by selecting it in the menu list up here. Click on it and select your camera, which will be found at the very end. Remember that the new camera is positioned at the same place as the object node, so it's normal to see it from very close. You can move this camera the same way as the implicit perspective view, so let's try to find a better angle. Back in the inspector, you will find this time the camera component, which groups most of the camera's options. We have already seen those accessible from the setting menu, but two new ones are available in the inspector. You can set the camera into orthographic view by clicking on the orthographic checkbox, and change the field of view with the slider. You can drag into the field or directly set the value by double-clicking on it. As for the other node type, you will find again the name, the enable checkbox, and the transform component. The last type of node is a bit similar to the object node. It will not display a simple geometry, but an entire scene. So in the menu bar, go to Scene, Add, then Instance. This time, it will ask you to choose the scene that you will display from the project assets. I will choose this one and click on Select. The selected scene is now in your scene, contained in a single node. Select your instance in the Explorer. The icon is a little open box. In the inspector, you will see the new component for this node, the Instance component. This component allows you to access and set the linked scene to instantiate. Click on the thumbnail will open the related scene in a new tab. The Browse button allows you to change the related scene, and click on the Clear button will remove the link with it. The two next options allows you to start an animation automatically when the scene is loaded. The animation must be created inside the scene instantiate. You can choose one from the animation list of the scene by clicking on the animation field. The second menu allows you to choose the animation playback mode. Once we'll play the animation only one time, Infinite will go through the animation timeline indefinitely, and Loop will restart the animation as soon as it's finished. This is the end of this tutorial about the scene content. In the next tutorial, we will talk about the manipulation of all the nodes seen today. If you like our content, don't forget to subscribe, ring the bell, and follow us on social media. All links are in the description. Thanks for watching and see you next time with a new tutorial.